Wholesalers and retailers are two important types of middlemen which forms a part of distribution channels. They act as an intermediary link between the manufacturer and the consumers of goods. They specialize in providing a wide range of services for both producers as well as consumers. They reduce the amount of efforts required by manufacturer in distributing his product to the final consumer and provide vast market coverage to his products. They greatly increase the efficiency of exchange and lead to reduction in total cost of distribution of product. In this session, you will learn the role of wholesalers and retailer and their strengths and strategies for the success of a business. Let's begin with the term wholesaler. Wholesaler may be defined as the middlemen who operate between the producers and whom they purchase goods, and the retailers to whom they sell goods. Wholesaler refer to any individual or business firm selling goods in relatively large quantities to buyers other than the ultimate consumers. Wholesale intermediaries are a form of a link between professional vendor and the buyers wishing to trade a good. They carry out commercial operation on behalf of third parties, including the internet. Moving on further, let's study the function of wholesaling intermediates. Wholesale intermediates create time, place, and ownership utility as it provides opportunity by making product available for sale whenever consumer want to purchase them and deliver the good of service at intended location. Let's look at the wholesaling services which ultimate benefits a customer. These services provide transportation, storing, marketing, financing, buying and selling facilities as wholesaler sells goods to retailer in larger quantities, and then they are sold to final consumer which is in smaller quantity. Now look at the picture where transaction between manufacturer and customer is made through wholesaler intermediate, which referred as transaction economies through wholesaling intermediaries. Now what are the types of wholesaling intermediates? We can classify it on the basis of ownership and title flows. Merchant wholesaler are institutions that purchase goods from producer and then resell them to the other businesses, wholesaler or retailer. They can receive the title of the product from the manufacturer, holds product for inventory and then later resell them. Some intermediaries do not want to be bothered with the taking title or ownership of products. Agents and brokers are wholesalers whose main purpose is to facilitate sales. They help deliver product from the producer to the customers. They make their product by collecting a fee or commission based on the amount of sales they are successful at delivering for the producer. Let's learn the comparison of the types of merchant wholesaler and their services. We can see the table where merchant wholesalers are distinct from agent and broker in the way that they purchase the inventory they sell before profiting from it. This means that they assume a greater level of risk than the broker because they must assume financial responsibility for the product as they sell. Brokers do not assume this level of responsibility as they primarily serve as middlemen between the wholesaler and the retail purchaser. Let's learn what is direct marketing. Direct marketing is a channel of advertising which allow businesses and non-profit organizations to communicate straight to the customer. It adopts advertising technique that can include cell phone text messaging, email, interactive consumer website, online display ads, database marketing, promotional letters, and newspaper or magazine advertisements. Direct mail is a wide variety of marketing materials which includes brochures, catalogs, postcards, newsletter, and sales letters. Major corporation knows the direct mail advertising is one of the most effective and profitable way to reach out to a new and existing client. Direct selling is the marketing and selling of product directly to the consumers. Peddling is the oldest form of direct selling. Modern direct selling includes sales made through the party plan, one-on-one demonstrations, and other personal contact. A textbook definition is the direct personal presentation, demonstration, and sale of product and services to consumers. Direct response retailing is a promotional method in which a prospective customer is urged to respond immediately and directly to the advertiser through a use of device provided in the advertisement. These devices includes a coupon to card and mail, business reply card, toll-free telephone number, and hotspot. Most retail sales advertisements are direct response ad in one way or the other. Customer other merchandise by mail or telephone, by visiting mail order desk in a retail store, or by computer or fax machine. What is telemarketing? It is a method of direct marketing in which a salesperson solicits prospective customer to buy product or services, either over the phone or through a subsequent face-to-face web conferencing appointment scheduled during the call. Internet retailing is a form of electronic commerce which allow consumer to directly buy the good or services from a seller over the internet using a web browser. Alternative name are e-web store, e-shop, e-store, internet shop, web shop, etc. Mobile commerce describe purchasing from an online retailer mobile optimized online site or application. Automatic merchandising is a selling merchandise through a vending machines, which is also called as automatic selling. As technology advances, high-end products are being sold in vending machines. Wholesaling provides an expanded consumer market potential in terms of geographical location and consumer purchasing power, while at the same time providing a cash flow for the manufacturer. There are several major reasons for the importance of wholesaling. First, all goods and necessary supplies for their production which pass through some form of middle agent and wholesaling system. Advantages of wholesaling are diversity, prospects, and increasing cost. Secondly, for most small producers, an immediate geographic location is typically insufficient to provide and maintain an ongoing customer base for their operation. Disadvantages are limited quantity, higher production level, pricing, and production consistency. Now let's understand the term retailing. Retailing is defined to include all business activities relating to selling of goods and services to the final consumers. It is the final link in a product supply chain. In India, retailing is one of the fastest growing industries. It is estimated to be the largest single sector both in terms of turnover as well as employment. The Indian retail store has been undergoing a rapid transformation in past few years. The traditional format of kirana stores, grocers, etc. are being gradually taken over by the modern formats of department stores, discount stores, malls, supermarket, etc. Beside the large organized retail segment, which uses sophisticated technology and communication network and offers several benefits to consumer in form of availability of quality product at lower prices. It is also beneficial for the growth of economy because it provides forward linkage of mass marketing of processed and packaged goods. Let's look at the functions of retailing. Firstly, a retailer deals in different variety of goods, which is purchases from different wholesaler for selling to the consumers. After assembly of goods from the different supplier, the retailer preserves them in stores and supply these goods to the customer. The goods are kept as reserve stock in order to ensure uninterrupted supply to the consumers. The end objective of the retailer is to sell the good to the consumers. He undertakes various methods to sell goods to ultimate consumers. He caters to the needs of the customers even by supplying them goods on credit. The retailer grades the good which is left ungraded by the manufacturer and the wholesalers. They gather invaluable information with regard to likes, dislike, taste and demand of the consumer and pass on this information to the wholesaler and the producer, which are very helpful for them. Retail strategy is a marketing plan based on the facts that how a business intended to offer its product or services to the consumer. For example, a typical retail strategy might illustrate how best to place and display a company product in retail outlet and how to attract optimal consumer interest at those locations. Every retailer, like manufacturer or wholesaler, develop marketing strategies based firm goal and strategic plans. A retailer marketing strategy or retail strategy is concerned with two aspects. Firstly, selecting a target market, and second, developing a retail mix to satisfy the need of targeted market. Let's study selecting a target market. Before determining marketing mix, a retailer has to decide about the target market to be served. Target market selection depends upon size of market, profit potential of the market, and level of competition. Retailer base their target market on demographic, geographic, and physiographic factors. Ultimately, the retailer decide their target market on the basis of neighborhood.